各位同事。
Members, it's time and we have a quorum. I call to order the meeting of the panel on economic development. First item on the agenda, election of chairman and deputy chairman for the panel on economic development for the 2017-18 session. May I remind members that in accordance with Rules of Procedure, Rule 77.6, if a member is the chairman or deputy chairman of a government advisory body in respect of matters which the panel considers to be directly related to the terms of reference of the panel, the member shall not be the chairman or deputy chairman of the panel. Rule 77.7 states that a member shall not be chairman or deputy chairman of more than one panel at the same time. In House Rule 22 and Appendix 4, the procedure for the election is stipulated. Members are invited to make nomination. A valid nomination shall be made orally by a member, seconded by at least one other member who should not be and accepted by the member being nominated. I now invite nominations, please. Ms. Starry Lee. Mr. Chairman, I nominate yourself, Jeffrey Lam, to continue to stay as the chairman of the panel. Mrs. Regina Ip seconds the nomination, and I accept the nomination. And I'll now hand over to the deputy chairman. Are there any other nominations, please, members? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I declare Mr. Jeffrey Lam elected ipso facto as the chairman of the panel. Please come back to chair the meeting. Thank you, members, for your support. Next, election of deputy chairman. Same as what I just said, and now I'll invite nominations from members. Mr. Kenneth Leung. I nominate Mr. Alvin Young. Any seconder, please? Mr. Charles Mark seconds the nomination. Accept the nomination. Okay, any other nominations, please? No? So again, I'll count to five. 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Congratulations, Mr. Young. You elected the deputy chairman. Now proceed to the next item on the agenda. Schedule of meetings for the 2017-18 session. In the last session, the panel usually had its meeting on the fourth Monday of the month at 10:45. If members agree to the same arrangement, may I ask members to consider the proposed schedule of regular meetings as tabled. But please note that for the October and December regular meetings, the dates are proposed to be changed. If there is no objection, then we'll go by the schedule issued to you. Any objection, please? No? Fine, thank you. Next, items for discussion at the next meeting. May I invite members to refer to the list of outstanding items for discussion. 3 directors of bureau will brief the panel on the 30th of October on the relevant policy initiatives in the Chief Executive's 2017-18 policy address. If members agree to the tabled schedule of meetings, then the next meeting will be on the 30th of this month at 8:30 a.m. Okay, no problem with that. For the November regular meeting, it will be held on the 27th of November at 10:45 a.m. The administration proposes to take up 2 items. 1, proposed retention of 3 supernumerary directorate posts in the Airport Expansion Project Coordination Office under the Transport and Housing Bureau. 2. Proposed retention of one supernumerary post of administrative officer staff grade C in the Tourism Commission of the Commerce and Economic Development Bureau, Commerce, Industry and Tourism Branch. A member has asked to discuss the incident of cancellation of flights by Hong Kong Express. Now, we've talked to the government about this, and we're told that the Civil Aviation Department is now closely studying the report submitted by the Hong Kong Express, and it proposes to give a report to the panel at the November meeting. Okay? I think we need to give them some time to go through the report and to verify information therein. Is that fine, right, Mr. James Toh? For the Lemma Island Vessel Collision report, now, in 2 years, the government arranged for a closed-door session to read the report. And it's been several years, you know, this has gone on for several years. Maybe in the November meeting, we can discuss that. Or perhaps after consulting members, there could be another special closed-door session. Mr. Holden Chow, thank you. Mr. Chairman, there are three items. First, about Hong Kong Express. I wrote to you before, and I would like to have a discussion on that incident. Now, you said that we must wait for the complete report of the Civil Aviation Department. Yes, I can appreciate that, but please, I hope to take it up as soon as possible. That's the first point. Second point, Trade Descriptions Ordinance has been in operation for some time now. I hope that within this year, we could have a discussion on the prosecutions and enforcement manpower and so on in relation to the ordinance, so we know whether there is enough manpower to meet the increasing demands. That's the second item. Third item is already on the list of outstanding items. The cooling off period review. Last year, already it's on the list waiting to be discussed, but of course we have to wait for the report from the Consumer Council on the review of the cooling off period. But it's been a year since. Let's see when we could discuss this item about the cooling off period. Thank you. Next, Mr. Lok Chung Hong. Electricity policy is under the jurisdiction of this panel. Now, for subdivided flat tenants, they already have to pay exorbitant rents for appalling conditions, but many are charged exorbitant electricity tariffs by landlords. And so far, under the current legislation, there's no way to control that. That's why I have drafted a private member's bill on the sale of electricity. There should be regulation to ban profit making from selling on electricity. I hope there'll be time for the discussion of this bill. Thank you. Next, Mrs. Regina Ip. For the two items proposed by the administration, is to do with government posts. There's nothing directly to do with economic development. The cruise terminal, right? That's under this panel. I think the government has to report on the business of the cruise terminal. Understand that in Shekou, there's a cruise terminal all ready to go, and they will become an anchor terminal. And so in Bay Area already, there'll be several cruise terminals. How are we going to handle the coordination and positioning? I think the government needs to explain to us. Mr. Yu Si Wing, thank you. In the policy address this year, there's mention of nurturing tourism talents, and also creating premier tourism destination. Now we've been investing heavily on some tourism destinations, spending hundreds of millions of dollars. But actually, we have a lot of good natural tourism resources. I want the government to tell us what this plan is. Ms. Gaudimo. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. About land sale. Yes, Mr. Chairman. Yes, yes, I'm listening. On the land sale policy, this panel can take that up, right? Yes. Land sale has got nothing to do with this panel. It's like this morning. This panel, now you're smart. Even if a land sale has nothing to do with a panel, you can sort of, shift the focus a bit and see if we can take it up. But if it's purely land sale, then it has nothing to do with us. I'm talking about the economy, really. Our land sale policy, the high land premium policy, the highest bid wins because it's a free market. But then in recent years, we see red capitalists compared to their acquisition of land compared to that of local developers, it's totally lopsided now. Local developers cannot compete at all with state enterprises and state capital. Let's say a site is $40 billion, but they put in a price of $50 billion. Of course, they're going to win the bid. So what sort of free market is that? Is it possible that we can talk about this? Okay, and then another item, harbour development in Hong Kong. Hong Kong was once ranked first or at least second. The Rotterdam was the number one container terminal, but then Hong Kong is slipping down the ranking substantially. Even Ningbo has surpassed us. So shouldn't we have a proper discussion on our port development? Port development, there are two aspects. One is about cargo. I believe you're talking about cargo, right? TEU, right? TEU throughput. I think that's what you're talking about. Okay. Next, Ms. Ari Lee. I'd like to propose two more items to be put on the list. How we could make good use of the cruise terminal, apart from its positioning. I'm also concerned about what Mrs. Regina Yip just mentioned. I've been following the news. I see the cruise terminal is really rarely frequented. It's at a wonderful location, and it's nicely built too, but there are few tourists going there, so we could do better. I want the Bureau to tell us how it could improve upon the functions of the, or leverage further on the functions of the cruise terminal. The other is about tourism support facilities. Now, apart from tourism destinations, we see there are tourists coming on low-fare tour groups, and they mostly stay in North Point and Cullen City to spend. In terms of car parking spaces and other support facilities, there are none in these areas. So these areas really suffer as a result of these two groups. So I think the government should have a series of tourism support facilities. So group tours won't be causing too much of a nuisance to different districts in the territory. Another issue for consideration this morning at the Financial Affairs panel, a study visit was proposed, and there's mention also of financial development in Bay Area. Now, financial affairs, of course, are closely related to economic development. If we are to study the financial development in the Bay Area, we can also see how that helps economic development in the Bay Area. I hope that study visit will take place, and I hope it will be a joint panel visit. Thank you.
Mr. Jeremy Tam. Thank you, Chairman. I would like to talk about the third one-way system project, because at the subcommittee, we are not able to extend its tenure. And as we know that the airport costing on 1.15 billion for the project is no small sum. If the subcommittee decide to fold, I think we need to follow up at another panel. I would take a reference of the XRL. Maybe for every 6 years, the airport authority submit a report whether on the progress or the capital flows, as well involve the issue of debentures and bonds. Especially if we care about the progress of the works, whether it will go over budget, they will be of our top concern, among others. If we lost the subcommittee, we would focus on that. There were two ways of thinking. Would you consider for every year, let's say for a tourism board, they would need to report to the panel every year or a second. Besides that, maybe every 6 months they need to submit a report. So we have this from the XRL, and you still went over budget. If we don't care about the third one in the next few years, when it comes over budget, that's not something the members or the public would like to see. Last one, Mr. Kenneth Leung. I respond to Andrew Mr. Starry Lee on this study visit at the panel, chairman of the panel of the. I will agree with the big areas center. Maybe in the future we'll consolidate the members' views. And I think of a joint panel together with the industrial commerce panel to have a tour of the some cities in the Bay Area. So hopefully we can achieve that within this session. So there are a lot of items, but first I read out two items proposed by the government. And I also would deal with the item on the Hong Kong Express with the recent cancellation issues. So do we agree that we should deal with three each items and we'll deal with the rest later? Okay, agreed. And for the Lama Island collision, I will liaise with the Bureau to see. I will relay my discussion with the Bureau to see when they can come to this panel. Whether it's November or December. So I'll communicate with them and report back to members. So Mr. Chow, is okay? Chairman, I say the incident is long overdue. And it's been 2 years. I don't want to see as a procrastinating that some of the victims' families may have the impression that we as a whole don't take this seriously. I hope that the chairman can consider this. So we just agreed on three items. This is probably a matter of time, so if not, we can have a longer meeting. So among all these items, I should need to communicate with different bureaus. And like I said, I would first report this panel that when do we deal with. I hope this will be as soon as possible. I don't mean to drag on, okay? Chairman, I found it strange that on the Hong Kong Express item that you have to raise that first. I apologize for my unwell. You claim that the Bureau is ready anytime to discuss the report. That's my understanding. Because I know that things that happened in the things underway for the past few years. As you're asking why the Hong Kong Express have they arranged it so quick, because it's written letter and then we can actually communicate with the Bureau and which had responded. So because you bring it up just today, of course the past discussion with another thing that has been included in the outstanding item list for quite a long time. Like I said, I will do it right away. I will communicate with the Bureau. As for the other items, if we claim writing to the administration, You were the chairman of the last session. Okay, so let me consult with the it's not that I'm not putting it in November, but give me a chance to talk to the administration, because when you bring them last time, they will have a new developments. So I shall report to Mr. Cho and the members. As for the trade description ordinance, cooling off period, and so on, I shall liaise with different bureaus. As for the overcharging of electricity by landlords, I will deal with that in due course. So each item has their own urgency. As for the item raised by Mr. Yu, in the policy address, we touched on that as well. So if you're not able to get an answer, I will include it in the to deal with this at this panel. Maybe I'll mention it briefly. I hope there will be more details that in terms of green tourism or unique, and so also planning considerations. That day, we have quite some time. I have no idea how long we get the responses. Like I said, if not able to provide an answer or information you need, then we would include it in the agenda and invite them to come over. And as like the cruise terminal item as raised of Star Relay, as well as supporting facilities and so on, we could deal with that on the same way. These two items are considered relevant to each other. If on that day they're not able to provide the answers you like, I will put this in the agenda and we invite them over to this panel. As for Ms. Claudia Mo's item, you claim that the Highland premium on the impact of the Hong Kong economic development. It had more to do with the Highland premiums, but rather the incoming red capitalists as compared to the strength of the local developers. Now that our land parcels have been owned by outsiders, will there be other considerations? I can only see it on the economic perspective. I get your drift here. For the issues arising from it, probably might not be discussed under this panel. You can ask this question on the relevant departments under your way as to who buy or who sell those land parcels. That's the Development Bureau's ambit. That's from what I know. So how does the Highland Premium affect our economy? That's the question. Well, that the way you ask me whether it's okay when you're with a laughing face, of course I will say yes. I could have make a really long face, but I feel that I should try my best in this case. I know what you mean. I think that this is the panel on economic development, and the Hong Kong's economy has been getting more mainlandized. You claim that it's a development issue, that I understand your dilemma, as we have a terms of reference. As for Ms. Starley's item on the study show on the Big Bay area. Big Bay included Daya Bay as well. Bay Area, rather. Besides Daya Bay, we need to visit the Bay Area as well. It's really worth to visit. Pardon me, Chairman. When in your reply, you claimed that the cruise terminal would put it under the inquiry to the secretary. I accepted this on the supporting facility with tourism. However, I hope that they can give an account on the cruise terminal. We can see the situation that it could be so much better. And I hope that they can come here to explain. You know that we need more time to digest this long report. We all cared about the development of the cruise industry as well as the peripheral development. Maybe I can invite the bureau to come to this panel to give a briefing as well as to answer members' question of their concerns. And for the third one-way system, now that the meeting's coming, as that subcommittee's come to close, that the relevant Bureau Department should come here regularly for questioned members, that I would discuss with them, what if we say, for every 6 months, 9 months, and so on. I heard that you hoped it happened every 6 months. The panel usually, I'll discuss it once a year. So for every 6 months could be hard on you. I hope that there will be have a written progress report on the capital flows for every 6 months. These are the crucial aspect in line with the high rail project. And for the Bay Area study tour, I will discuss that with the panel on financial services to see how we should proceed. And once we get some answers, I will brief the members. Any other business? So the members have agreed that the November regular meeting agreed to discuss the three items, and the next meeting will be start at 10:15, slightly earlier, as we quite have an extra one more item. As for the items for the other months, as members have bring up a lot of items that me and the Vice Deputy Chairman would need some time to prioritize. As the Chairman of this panel, I shall invite the relevant Bureau Directors to this panel in this year plan, which included issues for. If there are any items you would like to discuss, you can submit them in writing to me. AOB? None. So I declare the meeting adjourned. Thank you all.